331 kilometers Bwindi Impenetrable National Park, which harbors admired rare species, rather aroused the curiosity of tourists, would be no penetrable was it not government's decision to evict creatures. About 27 years down the road, government through Uganda Wildlife Authority has registered achievement of saving the forest, thus promoting tourism and environment. However, in Bufundi sub-county, Rwandi district, many communities, in Butwa in particular, have been attacked by jiggers.
Gwanisa Mavunja na nekitongole cha Emma na Weyija.
We have been fighting against jiggers for about 4 years. The houses we have been using are in poor state. That's why in some families, jiggers are persisted.
So tu kujezao kujanga Mavunja agarugeho konga family ki ibiri. Nizo zikaji zirechi.
In Nyakabunga village, the situation is alarming. We have been buying paraffin to fight jiggers, but in vain. Locals of this area said the infestation previously killed an old woman who was living alone in the ramshackled hut. We haven't buried a child because of jiggers, but it may soon happen. When a child is weakened and can't walk because of these parasites, what do you do?
They are unable to get income, for example, to buy, let's say, soap, or let's say, any other basic necessity like good shelter, then you don't expect them to have good hygienic conditions.
In Chichasha village, where epidemic has caused school dropout, leaders front poor hygienic conditions in these communities as the underlying factor.
In 2016, we had an allocation of 43 billion shillings. But what we received as a Minister of Gender was just 28 million shillings. 28 billion shillings. But with the 28 billion shillings, we are able to reach out to around 50,000 groups of people, women groups. Around 50,000 women were able to benefit, and they were able to pay back. So we are really convinced that when we move with women, we have moved with the rest of the world.
We need to appreciate that the Batwa are indigenous people and are forest people who used to depend entirely on the forest. So this kind of life in the community is very new to them.
In 2010, a report by ActionAid showed that Uganda is one of the countries with high cases of jigger outbreaks, especially in 12 districts of Namutumba, Busoga region, and apparently it's in other districts like Shema and Buhejo in western Uganda. Report by Halson Kagure for Urban TV.